Are you struggling to import your own data into BQool using a spreadsheet? Today I'm gonna teach you how to achieve this using our bulk upload and some Excel magic. So as you might know, to use a repricer, you need to input min prices, max prices, and a rule. Those are necessary values. And also you might want to input cost values for better calculation. So you can definitely input this and calculate these values within BQool itself. But what if you already have this data somewhere else in a spreadsheet? So you can actually upload a file into BQool to import all of these values. But you need to do a bit of work before being able to do this. So let's see how to do this. First of all, why do you have this data in a file? Maybe you're just taking care of this file manually by yourself, or you might have exported it from an inventory management tool or any other software or tools that you're using. So if you have this file, you obviously have to open this file first and making sure that your file contains all of your data. Then you need to work with our own files. So let's see where to find it and how to download it. First of all, you go to the section called Upload File. In here, you need to download two files. One is your full template. It means all the data already in BQool about your listings. And the other one is called blank template. This is basically a template that you are gonna fill with your data, and then you're gonna save it and upload it. I already downloaded this for you. So let's see how the Repricing Central file works, the blank template. In here, you have different tabs. The most important one is the data definition. In here, you're gonna see each data, what it means, and which one of them are required. The one in yellow are required. So whenever you're uploading a file, always make sure that these values in yellow, this column in yellow, are there, are present, and they're not missing. If you don't want to update any of these because you already put them, just keep the column with the existing values and don't change anything, but keep it there. When we go to Repricing Template, this is where we're gonna actually work and we're gonna put our new data. So for example, right now we can see that everything is blank. So what we can do is we can open the full template that contains, in a TXT file, it contains all the data that are already in BQool right now. So we can simply just copy everything and paste it in our file. Now, of our data has been already input because it was already present in BQool, but most of it in this example is still missing. So we want to, for example, add min prices and max prices from a file that we have. So if we check the file that I have called my own file, we can see very simple. I put the SKU that are necessary, a cost, min price, and max price for each of these SKUs. So we want to make sure that these values are going to go into our template in BQool. So of course, the first thing we need to do is we need to copy this data into the BQool file. So we create a new sheet and then we go and copy everything and put it into the new file. Once we have done this, we have everything in one file only. The next step is to match the SKUs from one tab to the one in the other tab. So we need to use a formula called Vlookup. This formula will help you find the data in the file we already had and put it into the one for BQool. So it might be a bit complicated. You can look up how to use the Vlookup more thoroughly online, but it is actually pretty simple once you have learned how to use it. So for example, we can go on the first column and we want to add all the min prices again from our file. So in the first line, we're gonna put the formula. So it's called VLOOKUP. What comes after? The first value we need to put is which value to match. And in this case is the SKU. So we're gonna just put the B line and a comma. Then we need to say in which table to look for. And we have to go on the other tab and choose from SKU to the last value, comma. And then the next is which value we want to take. In this case, we want to take min price. So we need to count which one is it. So SKU is number one, cost number two, min price number three. So in here we put three. And the last one is just if we want an exact match or approximate match. We want an exact match. We close the formula and we push enter. So now we have this 440 is actually the min price that we had already stored in our file. If we want to do this for all the SKUs that we have, we can simply select everything and push Control D. The system will copy the formula in every column. We didn't put all of our SKU in the other file. So when we see NA, it means that there is no data from the other file. But the one that I actually put, they're now populated. So all the min prices that we do have in our own file are here now. And we can repeat the same thing for the max price, for the cost. You can simply just copy the formula, put it into the max price one, and just change the number. So number 3 was min price. So max price is gonna be number 4. So we just change the 4 here. Everything else stays the same. And we can repeat the same operation we did before. So the moment we do this, the data from one spreadsheet is passed through the other spreadsheet, is our own. But now we still need to do a couple of more things. First of all, we need to stabilize the data. So right now, everything in here is just a formula. It's not a real number. So what we can do is we can copy it and then choose to paste special. Because instead of just pasting, we are pasting values. We click values. Okay. And now these are all actual numbers. Before saving, you can actually change other values in here. I'm not going to go through all of them. But for example, if you're deciding to add listings to groups, if you already have groups in BQool, you can decide which one of your listings is going in each group that you have. So you simply put it down in this column. And this whole thing is going to happen at the same time when you're going to upload the file. There is two more things to do before being able to save the file. The first one is to eliminate everything that doesn't have data, because we saw there's an NA. We don't want that, because otherwise the system is not going to recognize the data. So the first thing we can do is we can filter the new values that we've put by using the filter option and only select everything but N and A. This will eliminate everything else. But data is still there, so we need to actually make sure that only the existing data, the one showing, is going to be imported. So what we can do here, we can select everything and go to Find and Select, go to Special, and choose Visible Cells Only. After this, we copy, we create a new sheet, and paste. Now, we're only going to have the data that we've inputted, nothing else. The file is going to end where the min and max data ends. Remember that you need to fill in the rule as well. We haven't done it, but remember that this column, rule name, needs to be filled completely. After we have done this, we can stay on this sheet and save. We need to save the file in a format that is accepted by BQool. The format accepted by BQool is text tab delimited. So we choose this format and we save. After we save the file, we are ready to upload it. We go back to upload file in BQool and we go to choose file. In here, we select the file that we just saved and we click upload now. After we have clicked this button, the system is going to process the upload. We can actually go scroll down and see the section called Review File Status and History. In here, we can see if the upload was done, first of all. And after it has been done, you can check how many records that were processed, which one were actually activated. It means everything went successful. But also the number of records that had a problem, there was an error. The error could be because the formatting was wrong or because the data was missing. You can actually click in here, View Processing Report, and you can see which listings were not processed and why. That's very important. So you can actually maybe work on the Excel again and just fix the one that had problems. I hope using this method will help you upload the file easily and quickly in BQool. If you still have problem with the upload and with the format, you don't know exactly what is the problem, you can just write to our support at support@bcool.com, or you can just leave a comment below in the video. And lastly, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel.